Final preparations are underway for the plebiscite tomorrow, which will decide if Palawan will be divided into three distinct provinces. Poll officials are making sure health protocols are in place during Saturday's historic vote. Adrian Ayalin is there and he joins us now with the latest. Adrian, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina, last-minute preparations are being done by teachers of Andres Soriano Memorial Elementary School for the plebiscite tomorrow on the proposal to divide Palawan into three provinces. As you can see behind me, that's the principal office, and teachers are on standby there. Some of them have already claimed their anti-COVID supplies for the plebiscite. Some of them took the supplies on foot, while some took their own motorcycles and picked up the supplies and brought them for safekeeping until tomorrow here in their assigned precincts. The Commission on Elections and the Department of Education officials were the ones in charge in the distribution of the anti-COVID supplies being done in a gymnasium near Andres Soriano Elementary School. Also, the ballot boxes, they were inspected by the teachers, but they had to remain in the gymnasium, and the ballot boxes with the rest of the election paraphernalia will have to be distributed tomorrow by COMELEC before the polls open at 7 a.m. Now, just to give you an idea of how this plebiscite will be done in this time of COVID-19 pandemic, this is one of the precincts here at Andres Soriano Memorial Elementary School. And the usual Board of Election Inspectors that we see during elections, they will be called Plebiscite Committee. It will also be composed of three persons, teachers and poll clerks, who will have to conduct the election process. Again, because of COVID-19 threats, there are booths installed by the Commission on Elections. There are five chairs. Only five voters will be allowed at a time, of course, to ensure that health protocols are being followed. Now, in case there is a spillover outside, the others, the voters can wait outside so that the five person plus of the three person plebcom will have to be maintained inside the classroom. Now, there are chairs provided outside the classroom, so in case more than five voters arrive at a time or at the time, they will have to wait here outside the polling precinct. But aside from that, there are also isolation polling places. That's one of the requirements of the Commission on Elections. And there's a gym beside me for Andres Soriano. That's their isolation polling place. There's also a booth there with plastic cover. And that's the area where the voter who registers a temperature of 37.5 degrees Celsius or more, or answered yes to any of the questions in the health declaration form, they will be allowed to vote, but they're in the isolation polling place. Again, the wearing of face masks is mandatory, but wearing of face shields is just encouraged, according to election officials. The polling places will open tomorrow, 7 a.m. up to 3 a.m. The Commission on Elections has said that because of this, voting process will be done manually entirely. The COMELEC said, Commissioner Antonio Co said, that the earliest that we will have a result of the plebiscite, either yes wins or no wins, is on the 16th. Again, it may be delayed, but we can also expect that it could be early. But definitely, we will not have a result on the same day, because again, there are island municipalities and there are also island barangays. Even here in Rojas Town, which is a part of mainland Palawan, there are also island barangays. So the bringing in of the election materials after the election will have to be difficult. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Adrian Ayalin there joining us from Palawan. You take care, Adrian. You keep safe.